Our today lecture is related to bearing. Here I write three type of bearing. First one is slipper bearing, second one is slip bearing, third one is radial load bearing. First we understand about slipper bearing. These bearing are used for a straight line sliding. Means in this bearing, sliding occur in a straight line. These bearing be used in a external combustion engine for a cross head. With the help of cross head, we connect the piston cylinder alignment. In this case, or in external combustion engine, piston cylinder is not directly attached with the crank. If we take internal combustion engine, then in internal combustion engine, piston cylinder alignment directly attached with the crank. But in case of external combustion engine, we used one more mechanical part, that is known as cross head. After the cross head, with cross head, the crank is connected on the external combustion engine. So for cross head we used slipper bearing, because the in this slipper bearing, sliding occur in a straight line, and also used in a scotch lock mechanism. This is a mechanism, this converts rotatory motion into reciprocating motion. Here you can see this will crank, and this is converting rotatory motion into reciprocating motion. In this case, here you can see we talk about mechanism. In mechanism, if smallest link is adjacent link of upper link, then it convert rotatory motion into reciprocating motion. If smallest link will fixed link, then it will convert rotatory to rotatory motion. Means if we take crank as a fixed link, then this will convert rotatory to rotatory motion. Means it will fully rotate the other two link. So this is some description about the mechanism. So we use slipper bearing in a external cross head of the external combustion engine, and the another place which is in a scotch yoke mechanism. We talk about slip bearing. Slip bearing, in this bearing, sliding occur in a circular direction. So they are used for a shaft. In this bearing, sliding occur in a circular direction around the periphery of the circle. So this is used for the shaft. First one is pivot bearing, also known as footstep bearing. In this bearing, sliding occur along the periphery of the circle. Here you can see the sliding will occur only around this periphery. In this also, around this periphery sliding will occur, and this can only take the axial load along the axis. Here you can easily see this will axial load. So there are two type of pivot bearing. First one is flat pivot, and the second one is conical pivot. And the second type of the slip bearing is a collar bearing. These bearing also take axial load. This is axis of the shaft. In this bearing we used collar. If we take a 3D view of this bearing, then this will something like this. So this will collar. These are also of two types. First one is flat collar bearing, second one is conical collar bearing. In this angle is known as con angle, and half of this angle, this is 2 alpha, half of this angle is known as semi-conical angle. This can also take axial load. So this is our slip bearing, and the last one is radial load bearing. Before that, we understand about what is general. General is also a part of the shaft, but the part of the shaft which is inside of the bearing, this is bearing. The part of the shaft which is inside of the bearing is known as general. It is also a part of the shaft, but the part of the shaft which is inside of the bearing is known as general. So radial load bearing by name, it is specified, it can take radial load. It is of three types: partial general bearing, full general bearing, fitted general bearing. So this is about short description about slip bearing, slipper bearing and the radial load bearing. Slipper bearing be used in cross set of external combustion engine in a scotch oak mechanism. Slip bearing be used for the axial load purpose and the radial load bearing be used for the radial load. Thank you.